Hey there, welcome to the Wendell Weekend Show. This show is about community, great people doing great things in a great place. It's about Wendell. I'm your host, Christy Adams, and I'm proud to call Wendell home. All right, guys, today is not just about the rainy, dreary weather and bad hair and rain-spotted glasses. It's actually about the community coming together here in downtown Wendell to celebrate International Food and Music. We are here for the 9th annual International Food and Music Festival put together by St. Eugene Catholic Church, and we're gonna see what it's all about. You got red beans and rice ready now? Yeah, hit me with the red beans and rice.
We'll hit you. If you wouldn't mind, you can put the 6 tickets in the box.
Sure.
Over here, and I'll take care of the rest.
The 6.
What we got is, if it's not spicy enough, you can kick it up around the corner, because you always want to be able to kick it up a notch. It's hard to take it down, though, if you know what I'm saying.
I know what you're saying.
Morning, how you doing? Thanks for coming out today. How's that gumbo?
Good. It's worth it. Worth the rain. With Dawn Jones. She is the food booth chair for the International Food Music Festival.
That's right.
9th annual festival this year, and you've been doing this all 9 years.
I have.
So tell us a little bit about what goes into putting all these wonderful food dishes together and making them available to the community.
Well, each booth is sponsored by our parishioners at St. Eugene, and they, as you can see, they come from all different backgrounds, so they are very proud of their specialty dishes, and they will each choose one or two of their specialty dishes and prepare them for this great event that we have.
How did the idea, 9 years ago, how was the idea born to do an International Food and Music Festival?
That's a great question, and it was a great idea and a great concept. We wanted to build community within our church as well as within Wendell. We wanted to bring this to our community here, and it has built great fellowship, and we've all learned so much from each other and our own backgrounds, and it's been a wonderful, and that's why I do it every year. It's wonderful.
Yeah, this is no doubt one of my absolute favorite festivals. We have two really big ones here. This is one of them. We also have the Harvest Festival, and we're known for both of them. Folks from all over Eastern Wake County and beyond come for International Food and Music and the Harvest Festival. Now, my personal favorite here is the Cajun booth. Do you have a favorite?
I do have a favorite. Okay. I can say... I have two, because I have to say this, and I'll justify it. I am Irish and I'm Italian, so I have to choose Irish and Italian, and that's what I'm sticking to it. However, being a great, being in this position over 9 years, I do go to each and every booth to make sure all the food tastes good. So I do try to sample each and every booth. I have to report on it, so I do.
Yep. And I like you, sample. I won't say I sample all of them because my stomach, it fills up before I make it. But I do sample as many as I possibly can.
Yes.
And I am going to try the spring roll at the Filipino booth.
Down at the Filipino booth. Yeah. Wonderful. Spring rolls.
All right. Well, much success this year. I know the weather's not really cooperating, but it seems that folks are getting out and
they are.
Enjoying
the crowd
it anyway.
Is picking up now. It's wonderful to see people coming out.
Yeah, so much success, and we'll see you again next year, I'm sure.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Am I ready? Hey, how are you? I was born ready.
All right, 3, 2, 1.
All right, guys, it's a beautiful Saturday here in downtown Wendell. Last night, we started the weekend at First Friday Jazz at the Kela Company. You've already seen some of that. Now we're out this morning for the annual Community Day, which is a huge event put on by Wendell United Methodist Church. Happens every year. There's a church bazaar inside, lots of shopping. There's a classic car show between Universal and the Methodist Church. And we're also going to take a look at a special 9/11 memorial this year that's going to be done by Troop 515. It's a scout troop right here in Wendell. We're going to show you as much as we can of all that fun stuff, so stick around.
Color guards present the colors. This morning we pause. We pause to recognize those who unselfishly gave in service to others. Our firemen, our police officers, members of our town government, Mayor Broadwell, Commissioner Baines, Commissioner Gray, and Commissioner Adams. Tomorrow, September 11th, marks the 10-year anniversary of that fateful day when terrorist acts changed this country forever. September 11th, 2001, began as a pleasant morning, but suddenly that was all shattered as planes crashed into both towers of the World Trade Center.
All right, guys, Community Day is a huge hit. Lots of folks. I'm standing here with Tripp. He's a man here at the Wendell United Methodist Church. He is relatively new to Wendell, been here a short time, but he has been right into Community Day, hit the ground running. Talk to us a little bit about what kinds of things are happening out here this year.
Well, we started cooking chicken at like 4:30 in the morning.
Love it.
Yeah, I didn't, but it smelled, but it was chicken. Yeah. It was a good time. We've got all kinds of silent auction items, all kinds of different food stuff going on, hot dogs, all sugar stuff for the kids, and a bunch of classic cars that are amazing yeah. looking cars. I hope you got some footage of the cars. They're great. And just some activities for the kids over in the corner with the slides and bouncy houses and Dunkin' booths and all kinds of stuff. It's great.
Now, this is your first Community Day yes. here in Wendell. What do you think so far?
Insane. Insane. I'm so glad I'm not in charge of all of this.
Yeah, this is it's a pretty big deal here. People look forward to this festival all year. Lots of folks come out to support it. Who've been some key people in helping put this together?
Bob Privet, his wife Kathy, Henry Mazio with the chicken. I heard he's the chicken master. And he's been over there giving instructions all morning long out in the middle of nowhere in a chicken pit. Jill Herzog. And other people who I'm sure I could name.
Lots of other people.
So many people, I don't want to leave anybody out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, this is a fantastic event. The weather, it's a little hot, but great. I know you're needed somewhere else, so we're not going to tie you up much longer. I think we're going to stick around. We're going to hopefully see the mayor get dunked a few times in the dunking booth a little bit later. But in the meantime, we're just going to catch everything we can possibly catch. And hopefully we'll see you. Not running around crazy, but running around enjoying yourself.
Trying to.
And welcome to Wendell.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Oh, yes, Wendell, oh, yes.
Oh, I'm going to put you in the water.
Come on. You do better than that.
It's a girl.
Come on, heckler. Let's hear it.
It's a girl. In pink.
Yeah. Thanks for watching, and come join us in Wendell. For more information about Wendell, visit townofwendell.com. To learn more about what's happening around the community, visit and follow my blog at forabetterwendell.wordpress.com. You can watch the weekend show online at ewtv.org.